Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to understand what is blobs, file shares, queues, and tables. And we are already aware like these are the group of services and grouped under Azure storage account. Once you create it, you have options to store different based on different types of data. You can able to store the data in these options. Let's try to deep dive into this in this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's try to revamp what we have learned in our previous video. Like Azure storage account used to combine the core primitive Azure based storage services like blobs, Azure files, queues, and Azure tables in a storage account. And we have created one storage account in our previous video, and we have seen some of the properties of it. In this video, we will see each one options separately. So without further delay, let's begin to understand Azure blobs. So Azure blobs, as you can see, like a massively scalable object store for text and binary data, also includes support for big data analytics through data lake storage Gen 2. We will discuss deep about this one option later, but it's basically used to store object store binary data, meaning like what are binary data, images, video, music files, backup files, right? These kind of data can be stored in the blob storage. So as the blob indicates, binary large object, which is used to store the objects as a blob. And as you can see, allows unstructured data to be stored and accessed at a massive scale in blobs. So this is the concept behind the blob storage. It is used to store the unstructured data. So if you don't know what is this, in our previous video we explained, these are the unstructured data. Structured data means SQL, which is having a stricter schemas. So those are considered as structured data, but videos and images doesn't have any schema to bound. So it is called unstructured data. So these kind of data can be stored. So how it is stored? Once you have an account, then you can create a container, right? In our previous video, we created a container. In that we have stored one of the file. So that file also stored as a blob. Now, even now you can store images and even the videos, right? These kind of data can be stored. Why this has to be stored? As the modern business evolves, you have built an application, like you may have a TikTok or some other famous video portals where they will capture the image or videos, right? They have to process it very quickly. So they need to store somewhere. They use the blob storage. I'm not specifically saying about that particular TikTok. It is the concept, so, right? Whatever videos you upload, they need to store somewhere. And this is the very cheapest mechanism and very quick access to it. So that is what I mentioned here. So the hierarchy follows here. You have a container, then underneath immediately all the files will be stored. This is your blobs. What about the files? Azure files, it you see here, enables you to set up highly available network file share that can be accessed by using a standard server message block protocol. So what it means is like you can see from the diagram here, you create a file storage or file share. So you create a shares instead of you create the container. Here it will be considered as a each container or each folder is considered as a share. Underneath you can have some files and folders. So this is what your file storage. It is just assume like you have your computer, PC, C drive, D drive, E drive. In the E drive you have some folder that should be shared, right? Shared to some other people in your organization or in your PC in some other users. Typically in application development, people use some shared drive in the server to store the configuration files so that your web application or any application, common files will be stored there. It will have a read and write access. Same concept over here. So your objects or your files are stored as a files only. It whereas in blobs, all the objects are converted as a blob storage. Here, just you can assume like share folder available in the cloud. That is what we can say about Azure files. So when to use, like you have on-premise application and it uses some kind of share folders, and most of the application pointing to share folder files. So all these folder files will be uploaded here. The same, your application will just replacing the pointer to this cloud, right? Instead of pointing to your on-premise server, once you upload all the files in this file, this will act as a share folder. Then it is like a lift and shift. Lift and shift is nothing but just you are moving into some other place, then you are shifting the connection. That is what lift and shift is all about. So the example given, configuration files can be stored on a file share and accessed from the multiple VMs. So this is what your Azure files. Then queues, you can see here some of the example allows for asynchronous message queuing between the application components. So what it indicates is like why queue system is important. I will tell you now with some examples. Like you have a one application like a Facebook or Amazon, initially they create whatever, I'm not mentioning any social media, just assume it, there will be a very big social media portal. People are getting users, right? I mean, when you build application, a lot of people are getting in, signing in daily basis, like are they are doing some purchases, whatever can be, right? So once they made some order, right, we will stick to that. Some people are doing some big billion day sales, right? During that sales in some famous e-commerce platforms, they keep on posting the orders. So if they directly enable the access to database, meaning like the users are not going into database, what I'm saying is a web application directly hitting the database means if it exceeds the capacity of the database, then there will be a possibility like your database system will crash or the entire web application will crash. So instead, you can generate whatever the request came from the users, you can generate the queuing system. So whatever request it comes, it will be placed in the queue and you use some functions to process those queues. Then finally, it will reflect in the database. So this is what a concept behind the queuing system. So typically in on-premise, we already have some kind of queuing system, message queues we will say, that is very famous. So same functionality, it is implemented here. The reason is like you can store millions of queues over here and you have different processing options. So this is typically a queues. Then Azure Tables, it is nothing but a No SQL store for schema, less storage for structured data. So it allows you to store structured No SQL data in the cloud, providing a key attribute store with schema-less design. Meaning like, see, this is basically No SQL. No SQL, the concept behind that is like, there is no schema bound to it. Meaning like, initially you will define the table, right? When it comes to creating a customer, you define 10 columns. Then you keep entering the data. Here, there is no concept of creating a table. You just keep entering the entity. Say for first customer, you have a name and phone number. For second customer, you don't need to mention phone number. You can mention the emails. So different columns, you can keep adding it. That is the concept behind it. So it stores the data in a table format. That is why it said table, but there is no schema to be bounded. I will going to explain it in a demo so that you will understand it much better. So when you can use it is like store flexible data sets like user data for web application, address book, device information, other types of metadata for your service requires. Okay. So these kind of tables are preferred when there is no relationship want to be existed, no lookups, no foreign key, primary key to be enabled, but you can scale as a major, I mean, the scalability will be more. Okay. Those cases you can go for it. So with this introduction about these four types, let us try to jump into our Azure portal. Then let's understand each one of the options in Azure portal. Now already we have created the storage account. Once you create the storage account, we will get these options. So data storage, that is what we meant. The first one is the container. Containers are nothing but a blob storage. So once you see here, you can able to create the container. So once you keep adding the container, you will have different options. Here I'm going to store some images. So images is already exist, so it should be capital letter images for AWN images. Okay, this does not exist, so it will allow me. So these are two things. One is employee files. Now you can see this is stored as a blob type, and we already discussed about this. Now once I'm back over here, go to containers, this is the images. Okay, you can always come to this blade, the previous blade, right from clicking over here, so that it will prompt you here. Okay, so now we are in images. Now once you start uploading it here, you will came to understand it, how the data will be stored, how the objects are uploaded. Let me try to upload some of the images. Let me pull some of the images. That I will upload the logo, even I can upload the my videos as well. Even I can store those videos over here. When I need to process in my web page, I can use it from here. That is the main logic behind it. We will try to cover this access tier, hot, cold, and archive in our next videos. But now you understand, this is the core logic behind your blob storage. You create a container, underneath you start uploading images or videos. Even you write a code in your application, you redirect your code to store the data in this share path, right? I mean, not the share path, in this blob storage containers. This is the concept behind that. Now coming back to file shares. When you go here, I have created some sample file share. So we will try to create one new file share. It is asking for a name, AWN. I will say like demo file share. Okay, it should not be caps. It's my practice. That's why it's obviously coming like that. You can give some quota. I'm for testing purpose, I am not giving more than that. 1 GB is I'm storing it. So here it is hard cold as usual. You will check it out later. And now this is the file share. Now you can go and check it out over here, what it says. Like this is just nothing but a file share, and you can able to create a directory here. And whereas you see in the blob storage, there is no concept called directory. Here you can create some directories or upload the files. So this is one of the important difference. And now how you can mount it, right? You can mount it to your system. As I said, this is typically a share folder where you can access from different applications. Now I'm just trying to get the code. Once you click on connect, it will give you different options to connect to your different, based on what OS you use, it will provide you the code. So use this code. I'm going to mount or create a share in my local system. Just take this script. Once you click on connect, see this is the name it will provide. I'm going to create in Windows. I'm taking the Windows code here. So take this one, copy it, then minimize it. Let's go to PowerShell. Just paste the code. Okay, once I paste it, waiting for the response. Credential added successfully. I hope you can see here this particular file share, right? It is mounted in my PC. Let's look into it. Now go and check it over here. You can see this particular AWN demo just now we created, that file share is available here. You can keep adding some of the files over here. I'll just add one file over here and see how it behaves. So this is something like a suggested list, some files we use. So I will just add this text file as well in the share file, I mean in this share folder, and we can go and check it out in the after you press refresh. Those two files will appear here. So this is not the way you can able to do, but actually typically what I'm trying to say is there are easy ways you can able to connect, or you need to understand the difference. Now you can see the actual file it has stored is file, I mean the type it is stored as a raw file. Okay, this is what the important aspect I am trying to explain it here. Next, moving back to queues, we do not have any queues to create, right? We will skip that part for now. We will take it in another session. And moving to tables. So tables, as I said before, we can start creating the table over here. I will name it as AWN table demo. So as usual, it should not be a table with a name already exists in the current scope. Okay, demo one. There you go. So once we have this particular table, we immediately get one URL. This can be used to connect to this particular table, and any programs can access it. And in order to enter the data, I need to log into Storage Explorer. This is some GUI or some client system that gives us the ability to connect to these storage objects, that storage accounts, whatever storage options we have, that will be listed here. Then you can start working on it, right? This will be available as a desktop version as well. We will explore it in our upcoming videos. Now, to explain how this No SQL concept behaves, let me try to enter some data. Add, here is the catch. You need to provide the partition key and row key. Let me put 11 here and add property. As we said, we are not creating any schema, just we created the name of the table, right? And now while in entering the data, inserting a data, I am creating some column. Here I'm pressing name, okay, then I press phone number. I just provide 11111, okay, just anything. It can be, it can be integer, you can change the data types. That's it. I will enter one record. Now this is one record. Now in order to add another record, I will put another record here. This row and partition keys are important. Now as soon as I didn't added anything here, but it automatically appears, I can remove this column, add another property like email. Here I will say analyticswithnags@gmail.com. next, and you click on insert. There you go. So now the key difference over here is what you can see here is like the schema or the strict, that it is not following a strict column approach, right? Well, if you are from SQL background, you may be familiar, like when you create a table, you need to define the columns, what columns the table going to hold. In this case, you are not mentioning any columns at the beginning. While inserting a data, whatever it is available to you, you are trying to insert. Now you can see you didn't mention name for it. You mentioned only email. That is also fine. So even you can keep adding some more records. So I mean, it will be the concept of No SQL is this. There won't be any stricter schema, no relationship can be established. I mean, those are the prerequisite. So I hope you understand different options, what are blobs and file shares and tables and queuing systems. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.